GMOs, genetically modified organisms. GMO is an abbreviation for genetically modified organisms. And you'll recall back in September of 2012, almost 2 years ago, a study was published in one of the peer-reviewed journals. It was published in Food and Chemical Toxicology, which is a peer-reviewed journal. You have to pass peer review. In other words, you have to prove to scientists of equal or superior academic credentials to you that the research that you did and the conclusions that you drew are legitimate. And it was published. And what it said was that rats who ate Monsanto's genetically modified corn that has been specifically genetically modified to be relatively immune to glyphosate, however you say it, Roundup. That people who ate this, that rats who ate this corn suffered liver and kidney disease and tumors. This is serious stuff. Well, there was this huge, Monsanto just unleashed this in September 13th, this major campaign to trash these scientists and their research. It got so bad that the original journal, Food and Chemical Toxicology, a year later, pulled the article and said, okay, we're unpublishing this article. Not because anybody had proved to them that it was false, but because it was just like this sustained barrage. Now they've republished it 2 years later, along in a new journal. This is the Environmental Sciences Europe, another peer-reviewed journal. They've redone the research. They found that their original findings were not only robust but repeatable. And they're talking about the PR and disinformation campaign that was launched against them in the new piece, in the new article. We're guinea pigs. Meanwhile, the USDA, the Department of Agriculture, the Food Safety Division, with chickens now, I guess this is, they're outsourcing to the companies themselves the inspection of their food. We have the highest rate of any developed country in the world of foodborne illness here in the United States. Because for 34 years, ever since Reagan came into office, basically, the idea that government is the problem, not the solution, we have been steadily cutting the budgets and diminishing the powers of the food protection folks in our government who were put into place as a result of, I think it was Sinclair Lewis, wasn't it, who wrote The Jungle back in 19-something? Say what? Oh, it was Upton Sinclair. Yeah, I always mix up my Sinclairs. It's Upton Sinclair. He wrote The Jungle. It was about meatpacking plants and how filthy they were and how deadly the food was. And it was like back in the 19-teens or the 1920s, something like that. We've always had this idea that, food is part of our commons. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. How can you have life if you don't eat? By the way, Ramadan Mubarak to our Muslim friends. May you have a blessed Ramadan. I only recently, I'm slowly learning things about various world religions, and I thought that when you fasted during Ramadan from sunrise to sunset, that you could drink water, because whenever I've fasted, I drank water. In fact, I drink a lot of water. The conventional wisdom for health fasting is drink a lot of water, right? Detoxify. But observant Muslims don't even drink. It's literally a fast. No food, no water from sunrise to sunset. I find that just an absolutely remarkable statement of commitment to one's faith. And it's those kind of really strong commitments that bind people to each other and to their commitment to their faith. I have so much respect for that. But back to the food. We are guinea pigs. here in the United States in this giant food experiment. I mean, we've just become guinea pigs. You, me, everybody. Some 70, 80, 90% of our corn now is this kind of genetically modified stuff or variations on it. You know, basically, unless you buy something that says organic on it or non-GMO, odds are extremely high. You know, particularly if you eat in restaurants or fast food joints or you're just buying chips from the 7-Eleven or whatever, that it's made with genetically modified corn. It's massive in the United States. And it could be caught, you know, if the study is right, and if what happens to rats happens to humans, which typically is the case, mammals are mammals. I mean, I've seen statistics on the rise, not only of obesity, but the rise of kidney disease in the United States. And people are assuming that somehow it has something to do with whatever's causing the rise of obesity, and there's all these different debates on that. You know, is it gut flora? Is it high fructose corn syrup? Is it people watching computers and TV? Do we need to go back to John Kennedy's having kids working out in schools? Does it start in childhood? Is there a virus involved? I mean, all of these things are possibilities. And there's been an assumption that the liver failures that seem to be associated with that somehow have something to do. Maybe not. Maybe it's GMO food. I think we are suffering in the United States from malnutrition. Now, malnutrition doesn't mean you don't have enough food. It means you have bad food. Mal is the Latin word for bad. Malnutrition means bad nutrition. We are eating things that are killing us. On the way in this morning, I stopped at Union Station, and there's a guy out there. He was selling blueberries and cherries, and I bought some blueberries and cherries. I'd be willing to bet, given how perfect they are, that they're laced with pesticides and herbicides. God only knows what. In fact, they probably came from some other country. Depends on the time of year. Actually, this time of year, they probably came from the United States. But whatever. It's like, unless you're going to go to Whole Foods, and then they're selling Eden Foods, who wants to deny their female employees birth control. It gets weird.